maybe have a chat with yourself. And, you know, some people might want to call it a soul or a spirit, but just as the indigenous people will tell you, you can reach out or reach in to that and get power from your inner self, from your spirit, or which what have you. And I think he was one that was able to do that and use it for good and to help teach people about their country and to feel good about themselves as a people. I believe that's kind of touching on where his strength came from.
I want to play another track here from the new collection. This is a song your father first released in 1977. Have a listen to this.
You hear every day how they're going away. I guess they just don't understand. The singer is the voice of the people, and his song is the soul of our land. So, singer, please stay and don't go away.
What are these top
friends? That is the singer off the new Stop and Tom Connor's album, Songs from the Vault Collection Volume 4. Tom Jr., Stop and Tom Connor's son, joins me now. What do you hear when you hear that song?
Well, when he was trying to make his own way in the music business back in the late 60s and 70s, he have a lot of problems trying to make a name for himself because he was such a singer of Canadian things. And it was a time back then where he saw a lot of his peers in the same business, you know, go elsewhere, leave Canada to try to make a name for themselves. And a lot of them were successful doing that. But he just felt that Canada needs more people to stay in this country and sing and work in this country to make us better that way. So I think that song was
make it better, but how can I make it better?
And also part to try to wake people up to say, you know, we as a people,
maybe I should learn
voice, and if we just
better paint
this country,
maybe
go elsewhere to prove in our creativity that our country will
creativity. I always needed that word.
They want us to hear.
Well, currently nobody wants to hear my story, at least not before.
Americanization
I think he's doing really well. This American
treatment of the Canadian artists up here. They weren't getting their just due in different organizations. And he had his words with the Junos as well about how they conducted their award ceremony. Giving Junos
maybe,
away to artists that
maybe live not so
and
good.
In another country, but then which is
not a good idea.
Have a good
and
time
that would
for a few
fun.
Days and then be back on their flight or whichever, back to whatever.
Maybe I should paint a little bit more on the black suit as you paint. The colors I do more of the pieces I do more.
Because... And of course, all the media at the time said, well, that's just a publicity stunt. And well, you know, it ended up being a 14 or 15 year publicity stunt, I guess, because he didn't bother coming back until the record companies started bugging him here in the late 80s and around 1990, he decided to come back out and put out a record and go on tour again, and well, the rest is history. So when I was a kid, I didn't even really know who Stomp and Tom was, to be honest, because he retired right around the time I was born in 76. And so he was just, you know, and my old man that was kicking my butt around the house here, teaching me right from wrong, and just a dad to me. So it wasn't until I was 14, 15 years old that he came out of retirement, and when school was done, I took a car ride up with my mom to Sudbury, of all places, for my first show. There I am out in the middle of the crowd, and when you know it, he points me out, of course, in front of 5,000 people, and so I had to get up and listen to the roar of the crowd, and I couldn't believe how everybody was going crazy for this guy that I just called Dad.
Sudbury Saturday night.
have a favorite? I mean, whatever you can say on the radio too. Do you have a favorite road story of being on tour with your dad?
No, I don't know. It's hard to give favorites because every day is a new experience with him and the boys on the road. And I just loved it. I loved traveling to all the different towns and meeting so many great people across the country. You know, Canada is unique. Different regions you go, people think and do things a little differently. And we have to understand that as a people, that we can't try to create a uniformity with everybody. We have to give everybody their own space, their own time, their own culture, their own traditions, and respect that. Regardless of the language or where you came from or the color of your skin, it don't matter. We all just want to be good human beings, and there's a place for everyone. And Tom tried his best to sing about as many people as he could, and he could only do that truthfully by getting out there and traveling and meeting all these people. And I would suggest that any young artists and singers or songwriters out there get off their butts and go see some of our country, and you will be inspired with creativity to write about your country and its people, because there's so much there to see and behold.
You're right about that. Before we go, and you've been great in speaking on behalf of your late father to us today about the collection of songs, about what he would think about the world as it is right now, stories about the songs and stories on the road. But how about you, Tom Jr.? Maybe this is a good way to close things off. How has this been for you? This, you know, opportunity to look back at your dad's legacy, because, to put some of these, you know, these songs together. And because to us, he's a Canadian icon, but like you said earlier, to you, he's just dad. Well, what's this been like for you?
As I said, it's my task, and it's a worthwhile task of to be bestowed upon me now to keep these songs alive for, you know, generations to come. I hope. His hope was that if he sang about his country truthfully, that his music would last as long as the country did. So it's important not just to keep Stompin' Tom music, but all of our artists and creative people, we have to give them an opportunity to shine in this country. Tom had a hard time making a name for himself, and if any time he could, he would try to inspire all the other artists he would meet along the way to don't give up, and to keep at it.
Tom Jr., thanks so much for your time.
Absolutely. Thank you very much.
Looking forward to chatting with you again about the next collection of songs. I've been speaking with Tom Jr., the son of Stompin' Tom Connors. Stompin' Tom's unreleased songs from the Vault Collection, Volume 4, Let's Smile Again, is out now.
so good. That is the great PEI singer-songwriter Al Tuck with a song called StompinTomConnors.com. Before that, you heard my conversation with Stompin' Tom Connors' son, Tom Jr. That is it for Q today. Tomorrow on the show, Maitreyi Ramakrishnan made headlines when she got the role for the Netflix series Never Have I Ever. 1 minute, she was a regular old teenager from Mississauga, Ontario. The next, she had her own show and millions of followers on Instagram. Season 2 comes out later this month. She'll be live on the show to tell you how it's going. We'll see you then. Later on.
PRX.
Here, nobody follows me. Just me. Why not? Let me get...
WNYC supporters include HSS, ranked best hospital for pediatric orthopedics in New York, New Jersey, and Connecticut, according to U.S. News & World Report, offering in-person and virtual appointments. More info at hss.edu/pediatrics.
New Sounds with John Schaefer is coming up next on 93.9 FM and on AM 820. It's the PBS NewsHour. At the start of June, New York launched a program aimed at helping residents who fell behind on their rent due to the pandemic. Tomorrow on Morning Edition, find out why tenant advocates say the emergency rental assistance might not be reaching residents who need it most. Tune in for this story on 93.9 FM, AM 820, or ask your smart speaker to play WNYC. A flash flood watch in effect through Tuesday morning.
This is WNYC, FM, HD, and AM, New York.
Okay, that sounds much better.
Well, you'll notice right away there's a crunchy sound to this electronic music, and there's a reason for that. This piece, called Dusk Tempi, is a collaboration between Matthew Cooper, who makes electronic music under the name Alluvium, and Stuart Hyatt, who records under the name Fieldworks, because all of his projects are built around field recordings. And this piece is part of the Fieldworks record called Ultrasonic, built around the echolocation sounds of a bat, the endangered Indiana bat. And I think you can hear those sounds a bit more clearly here. This Fieldworks collection is full of different composers doing really inventive things with those bat sounds. We've heard a few of them before on New Sounds, but we'll start this show with this track by Alluvium. And it'll start us off on a whole hour of electronic music, which will eventually work its way back to one of Alluvium's own records, but there'll be lots of other ports of call along the way as well. I'm John Schaefer, this is New Sounds. Let's begin with this collaboration between Fieldworks and Alluvium, and between those two humans and a bunch of bats. It's called Dusk Tempi.
By the way, this is not me, this is me painting here. I don't know why I'm doing it, but I'm painting here. It's not even that I know how to paint, but I love to do it. I have no money, believe it or not. I just don't make money. Because people don't pay me in the fucking place. Nobody could stop me from love, it's not
Surprisingly majestic sounding work, given that it is based on a field recording of the echolocation sounds of the Indiana bat, an endangered species, recorded by Stuart Hyatt, who records under the name Fieldworks, and this is from his 2-record set called Ultrasonic, probably the first album ever built around the sounds of echolocating bats, and featuring lots of guest musicians on that track. It was Matthew Cooper, who records under the name Illuvium. And Dusk Tempe is Illuvium's contribution to this Fieldworks record. And gets us started on this all-electronic edition of New Sound. Aliases, stage names, you know, Fieldworks, Illuvium, and now Isambard Kristalioff. Now you may well ask, who would choose a name like that as a stage name? I mean, usually you want something that's easy to remember. Well, this is the British composer and electronic musician Sam Britton.
Forgot then.
Chose the name Isambard Kristalioff as his alias from an album he did called Transhuman Harmonics, which looks both at the transhumanism movement, you know, this kind of idea that we can meld ourselves with machines and conquer death and illness and stuff like that, but also looking back to Ornette Coleman, the late Pulitzer Prize-winning jazz composer, sax player, and his harmelotics, which was this kind of organic fusing of harmony and melody and rhythm. And so Sam Britton finds a kind of analogy between those two movements in this record called Transhuman Harmelotics.